Thank you.
So how was your day at work today?
180 covers.
Too fast.
Too busy.
Too busy. So did you get what I told you yesterday? The
Of course. That is the reason I'm here. Okay.
You said 15 minutes.
15 minutes, your work is done. What do you need?
Just a mold.
Alright.
Some dark chocolate.
Uh-huh.
A spatula. And a scraper.
Alright. Yeah. That would be all to make
that
chocolates
would be
at home.
To make chocolate.
Sure. Alright. Let's go ahead then.
These are the molds that we use to mold a chocolate.
Alright, and this is what, plastic?
No. This is an acrylic mold. This is the costliest mold available in the market.
Is it?
Yeah. But you don't actually need to go with this kind of mold.
Uh-huh.
If you just want to start making chocolate as an experiment, the plastic molds are available as cheap as 10 bucks.
I have seen some which are like, when you push them from down, the chocolate pops out. What is that?
Those are the silicone molds. You see,
okay.
It becomes very easy when the chocolate is set inside.
Uh-huh.
Silicone is much more pliable, so just pop it out.
Alright, but which are most recommendable for a novice like me? I mean, I don't know how to make chocolates. So if I want to try making it or learning it, which one is the most advisable that I should use? It
depends on what kind of quality. See, if you're not very confident about chocolate not demolding, I suggest you go with the silicone mold.
Alright.
What happens is, they stick to your silicone, and as silicone is pliable, you just push off the chocolate.
Is it something related to the finish of the chocolate also?
Absolutely. When you do the scraping of the chocolate, silicone is a pliable substance. So when you scrape off, get that angle on it.
Shallow kind of.
Okay, so you won't have a total finish to your chocolate.
Okay.
What happens with this kind of molds are they are sturdy. Uh-huh. Okay. When you just scrape off the chocolate, you get a smoother finish.
It's like a complete.
So you have a uniformly smooth product.
Oh, wow. And how much do they cost?
This one is for around 250 bucks.
Alright, but then it has got how many? 24.
24 chocolates, and this is a lifelong investment you're doing.
Alright, that's nice. And what's that? A spatula?
That's a spatula. A silicone spatula.
Alright.
Used to
smoothen up.
Yeah.
Okay. We use a lot of this during our practicals and I chair together. Alright, so let's get to our work.
Yeah,
let's make chocolates.
And we are out.
So what chocolate is this?
We are using dark chocolate today.
Dark chocolate? And what other forms of chocolate are available in the market?
There are basically three forms of chocolate available. A dark chocolate, a milk chocolate.
And the milk chocolate is the one which is like the white, the milky bar?
No, that is a big misconception.
Is it?
That is a milk chocolate. That is a white chocolate actually.
White chocolate
does not contain any amount of cocoa solids. It is just milk solids, cocoa butter and emulsifiers.
So which chocolate is actually ideal for making chocolates at home?
You can use any chocolates for that matter. You can use a dark chocolate, you can also milk chocolate. Okay, as you can clearly see, the chocolate has begun to melt.
Uh-huh.
Okay, now you have to melt it to a point where all the granules, as you can see, this is a lumpy chocolate.
Alright.
It should be smooth paste. You should melt it to the point and you get a smooth paste out of your chocolate.
That looks smooth, nice.
Wonderful. Now I think we are almost done with the chocolate. Take your vessel off the fire, let it sit there.
So what do we do after that?
After that, you need to do is get your mold.
The ones which are in the freezer?
Yeah. Okay, they're in the freezer. Okay, now.
So what are you doing now?
This is the consistency of chocolate which you'll get once it is off the fire. Okay, if you get a little heat, yeah. All you need to do is cool it down a little bit so that it is ready to go into your molds.
Alright.
Okay.
So how much is the temperature variable? So what temperature you actually heat it at?
Now the maximum temperature to which you can take your chocolate is 40 degrees, max 45 degrees. If you heat your chocolate over 40 degrees, what will happen is, this is an emulsion of cocoa butter and cocoa solids. Oil will separate and your cocoa solids will separate. Which we don't want happening in case of our chocolate.
Why did you freeze the mold before you
What
did?
Happens is, this brings down the temperature of the chocolate.
Okay.
The sinus will be sealed instantly. As in when the chocolate touches the mold, it will seal the sinus.
Alright.
Okay. Now can I get a spoon please?
Do you need a small or
bigger spoon? A smallest spoon will do.
I have
various
sizes. See?
No, that is way too small. Let it sit for around a minute. What will happen is that you'll get an outer covering.
Okay.
After that, what you need to do is, please hold this.
Sure.
Take your vessel, just empty out the excess chocolate. As you can see, we have created a cavity inside this mold.
Mm-hmm.
Now, simple thing. Pick a raisin, shove it inside.
Sure.
Pick a raisin, shove it inside.
Can
Come
you
on.
Just say push or put?
Push. Take a raisin, push it inside. Take a raisin, push it inside. Okay, come on, help me out.
What raisins are these?
I have made this wine soap raisin.
Wine soap?
Yep.
I've heard of brown soap raisin.
Yeah. You see, everyone does the same thing. Why not be just a little different?
Yeah, and in fact, this is also made from grapes. And wine is again made from grapes. So, yeah, you compliment well. They're nice. Tasty. Good. Do we leave that open now?
No. We need to seal this up.
Alright.
So,
excellent.
Whatever remaining chocolate we have is going to cover this up.
I heard chocolate actually reduces blood pressure. It's got some enzymes into it.
Thing is, chocolate contains an enzyme called theobromine.
Uh-huh.
Now, theobromine is an enzyme which controls your stress levels.
Alright.
And as you know, blood pressure is directly related to your
stress.
But again, if you talk about chocolate, it is complete fat. Not too good for your cholesterol, but yeah, a small amount of cholesterol, a small amount of your chocolates can reduce your blood pressure.
And they are also said to be, chocolate is in the form of protein.
Yeah, so is salmon and so is all that. So if you want to believe it, believe it. But really don't care about it.
Alright. And do you scrape it again now?
Yes.
This is an art, my friend. This is not a craft. It's an art.
We go into the fridge and set.
Wow. So that's like 1, 2, 3, 4. 13 chocolates.
13 chocolates and it only took 4 minutes.
So, that's nice.
Go into the freezer.
Very well. Could we go into the freezer, a deep freezer or?
Yeah, if you want it really quick, deep freeze it for 5 minutes and it's done. Keep it straight.
Puff for you? Yeah. Puff, I tell you, it's done.
I say puff.